Hello and welcome to Wired In. I'm Diana Galata, Executive Director for Public Relations and Marketing for Hampton City Schools. Today I'm thrilled to be joined by Myra Chambers, who is Director of Alternative Learning for Hampton City Schools. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit first about your background and what path has led you to the position that you're in now for Hampton City Schools.
Well, I think I tell people, one, I have the best job in Hampton, citywide, schoolwide. I've had a really wonderful path. I've been blessed. Started as a teacher, became a dean at Phoebus and an AP later on. Then I was just fortunate enough to become the principal at Eaton, and then did 6 years at Hampton High, go Crabbers. And one of the things that really struck me as a principal is that I think in the state of Virginia, we're very program-based. We really look at programs and results and testing. And I think often we lose the individual factor in education. And I won't say I was disenchanted, but I think we can do more. I was an alternative ed kid, had some real significant discipline issues when I was in high school. My brother got his GED. And so when this job opened, I felt like it was the opportunity of a lifetime. And I thought I could take just the amazing experience I've had in Hampton City Schools then at the last 21 years and bring that to this role and really try to create an environment that can help students succeed, help students that feel like they're at the end of the rope and that we can get them a credential that they can really do something with, that they can go to community college, that they can get a better paying job, that they can actually graduate when they feel like they've dug themselves a huge hole. And so this was just a really, really perfect opportunity for me, and I just couldn't pass it up.
So your current job, you oversee the campus at Lee.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit more about the campus at Lee and what specific programs we offer there to help students who might be struggling.
Right. Well, we house 8 different programs, and I think what's really important is that we not only help the Hampton City School students, but we also help their families, too. We help adults there, too. So we have adult programs. We have adult English as a second language, GED, and the external diploma program, which is the adult high school diploma. We have the Performance Learning Center. We have the wonderful Bridgeport Academy, which serves students from grades 3 through 12. Then we also have an e-learning program. We have a high school GED program, ISEP, and we also have Homebound. So we have just this plethora of programs, and we're able to work with students as their needs change, that we can move them within our campus and with our staff who really love to be there and want to help every kid, and we can move them according to the needs so they can be successful.
So is it primarily a high school program, or do you have some middle school students?
Well, at Bridgeport, we serve grades 3 through 12.
Okay.
So we have elementary age students. We have students with special needs and accommodations that need to be met. We have a great middle school program. What we find is that students academically do very well. It's a great, it's a very structured environment. Kind of goes back to the core of what kids really need, the math, the reading, and working on the behavior so they can be successful in school. So at Bridgeport, we can serve students there to help set them up for success when they get to high school, hopefully. Then, of course, we have a high school program. Bridgeport has a high school program. I directly oversee an e-learning program and the high school GED. And then the PLC, the Performance Learning Center, serves grades 9 through 12 also, and they're in an e-learning format. So we have a number of different programs. We also have the Homebound program, where we serve a lot of Hampton City School students from all grade levels.
So it seems like to me it's more self-paced and about the individual student,
right,
really trying to come together with something that can really help the needs of that individualized student. Is that an accurate way?
I think it really is. And I think what we have to do is step back and look at education of, yes, we have a number of students that do amazing things. I was touched by students I had at Hampton High that went to Harvard and Princeton and, you know, wonderful universities, huge scholarships. But there's also a population of students that really need help. Family challenges, homelessness, pregnancy, disciplinary issues. And then that's not just what our campus focuses on. We focus on students that don't like the large school environment, that really want to do well, but are overwhelmed by having, you know, 2,000 kids in a school and having so many different teachers. So I think what we try to do is break it down. What does that individual student need and work out a plan to really help them and achieve? And we had great success. We had 65 diplomas come out of our little tiny campus. We're the little campus that could. And so we had 65 high school students graduate this year. We may have a few more this summer, and we're very proud of that.
And those are 65 kids who may not have graduated or might have dropped out.
Well, and what a lot of people don't know, these are some kids that are graduating early.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, so there's some students that say, I'm going to do well at school, but I need to make my own plan. Mm-hmm. And technically, there's no rule that you have to stay in high school 4 years. And if you're motivated and want to finish early and you have a need to finish early, why not? And so we have some students who come to our campus and really set on a path so they can finish high school early so they can go on and do things either that their family needs or to go on with further schooling. And so I think that's, sometimes people say, oh, alternative school is just behavioral issues. Mm-hmm. No, we have some very, very highly motivated students that like a calm, quiet, individualized environment where they have a real personal relationship with the staff and that the staff can work with them to help them navigate through school. And so it's not what people normally think. It's, sometimes I tell parents that my afternoons at the campus at Lee are sort of like a tropical island without all the adult fun, if you get what I'm saying. So it's a nice place for kids, and we have a environment and a staff that really want to help. They want to be there, mm-hmm. and they love that. That's their mission, and so I feel very, very fortunate to work with them.
So you mentioned earlier about the GED program, and I know that this year you and your staff had some great success. Mm-hmm. Talk to us a little bit about that.
Well, we had over 600. We had 675 adults in this area, out of state.
Wow.
And throughout the state of Virginia, finished their GED. The GED is renormed every few years to meet what they view as the high school standard. And so, of course, we're all familiar with the standards of learning, and the GED gets upgraded just the same way. The last time that happened was in 2002. And as you know, there are a number of situations that people put their GED off. And so they get into certain either financial constraints with work or family, and they don't quite get it done. My staff made it its mission that every GED they could get out the door, they would do. And so they stayed open the entire Christmas holiday. We tested on New Year's Eve until about 5:30 at night to get every person that could possibly get their GED done. And it was a lot of fun. I met amazing people from Hopewell, Richmond, Maryland, North Carolina, throughout Norfolk, had a ton of Norfolk folk. And I live in Norfolk, and so it was neat to really make a community connection throughout Hampton Roads. And really, their stories are so powerful. To meet and hear what they have gone through to kind of survive and that they still want to further their education. It's just a really powerful experience. And so it was just like one of the best things I've ever done.
Well, I congratulate you and your staff on making a difference to a number of people. That's phenomenal.
Yeah.
So is there anything else that you want to share with us about the campus at Lee or anything else associated?
Well, I think we call ourselves a little campus that could.
Okay.
And we serve over 600 over 600 Hampstead School students within our walls. We serve students virtually outside of our walls. Some students are served through Homebound or at home. And I think what is important for our community to know is that if they have an adult or a school-age student where school isn't really working, we're a real viable alternative. And at least what we would love to do is have a conversation to talk about what we could do to try to help. I think one of the biggest challenges for students, particularly in high school, is attendance. And I think if parents see that their student is really resistant to attending school, and there are lots of different reasons. It can be stress at home, it can be personal stress with the student, it could be just the environment, that there are options. And that's one of the beautiful things about Hampstead Schools. They try to think out the box, we roll, and try to evolve. And I think that gives students and families some real options to help them and help them be successful. So it's worth coming to have a conversation with us. They can do that at any time. Ms. Lipford, who is the coordinator for Bridgeport, and Ms. Fox, who's coordinator for PLC, and Ms. Wallner, we have regular discussions about what to do to help our students and work together as a team. And we will try to find a program that works, a academic system that works for students. And so, give us a call. We're always available, 727-1327. We have it on our grad specialist cars, and we really like to help folks.
And viewers who are interested can also find you on our website at hampton.k12.va.us.
They sure can. And my business card has my cell phone on it. My mission is to try to help every family. I was very, very lucky that my school system intervened with me. I was very lucky that there were folks that helped my brother get his GED. And we turned out to be rather successful adults. And so just because you have a little bump in the road or something might not be going well doesn't mean it's a permanent condition. And so I think that's one thing, is to just, maybe it's time to try something else, and to give us a call. We're more than happy to help.
I didn't realize that you were a student of alternative learning, so that's a great story to hear. Thank you so much for joining us today, and hopefully you'll come back in the future. I learned quite a few things today, and hopefully our viewers did too, and I'm hoping that if there's some viewers out there that heard something that might work for their own student, that they will contact.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you for watching Wired In. Have a great week.